apology will prove my love, it's true. I'll never get enough of you.
Melbourne Rock City has come down to the Prince Band Room early this afternoon, actually. We're out on the balcony. Joining me, Kate Miller-Heike. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. How are you?
I'm not too bad. Now, just to start off, we just saw you do sound check, and I'm pretty sure that's the first time I've ever seen everybody holding their ears. Not because it's bad, you sing so loud.
Everyone was holding their ears?
Well, they're like, oh my God, when you're hitting those high notes, because you just, like, it sounds good, but you sing so loud. That's not a bad thing.
Well, it shouldn't
it's
result
like
in people holding
it's like,
their ears,
it's like a rock
though.
Band in there. It's rock.
Yeah, well, you know, the guys that play in my band are rock players, and I think rock music and some of my more theatrical, operatic kind of influences share. They have a lot in common in that sort of surreal, ridiculous, over the top kind of thing. I like doing that. It's fun.
It is. And the new clip, Can't Shake It. Yeah, from Curiosa. Now that's cool. That's a cool clip. There's three Kates in that, which I was really interested in. There's the shopping Kate.
Yeah.
There's the exercise Kate. And then there's the star background dollhouse with the Adam and the Ants paint going on, which is quite cool.
Yeah.
Which is which is your favourite Kate?
Oh, look, I'm partial to them all, and I don't know. Well, I suppose in the clip, the goddess is kind of most representative. That's sort of supposed to be me. The goddess with a blackhead removal strip on her nose, as some people think it is. It's supposed to be Zinc. But
I think it's more Adam than
you.
Yeah,
thank you. That's kind of, that's, yeah.
It's definitely not
that's what we were going for. That's what we were going for. But yeah. Well, the goddess is sort of controlling the other Kate.
Yes.
So the whole thing is set around the premise of a doll's house, which is a reference to some of the album artwork. And it's each room in the doll's house represents the different songs on the album. But in this clip, I guess each room in the doll's house represents a different facet of my personality and what comes through in the music. I really wanted to experiment with blending some of those more organic elements with electronic stuff and lots of dinky old keyboards and some drum programming for the first time. We worked with a great producer called Mickey Petralia, and he's, well, in my humble opinion, he's one of the best drum programmers in the world. And I've tried to exploit his talents wherever I could. So it's more of a pop album. It's the brief that I was working to was joyous pop with heart, whereas Little Eve was basically a ragtag collection of the best songs that I'd written over the past decade. Curiosa is a more cohesive, concise work that was created over a short period of time, and yeah, it's very different.
When I was in high school, we'd ride side by side in the morning on our bicycles. Never even spoken or faced each other, but on the last hill we'd race each other. When we reached the wrecks, we'd each go our own way. I wasn't in his classes, I didn't know his name. When we finally got to speak, he just stared at his feet and mumbled a sentence that ended with James.
You said you've written this in a shorter period of time, sort of just happened creatively, it just exploded. How did that sort of affect you and with the album?
It was one of the happiest times of my life, you know? Like, I mean, I'm a songwriter, and I think most songwriters would agree that the actual writing process is the most fun part of the process when you're finishing songs. And especially, we had a little home studio set up, and so we got to record demos at home, and just to see the songs come together like that and to have total control over the arrangements, that was really exciting. And to get to do that for 2 months straight was, I felt so indulgent, but it was really, really good.
I've also noticed with the lyrics and the writing and the way everything comes out when you're performing, the lyrics are always put forward differently for each song. It's never the same. It's always, there's just always a difference to each one of the tracks. Is that something that you just concentrated on as well? Because you see a lot of artists that will spring out an album and you'll hear song after song after song, and the lyrics may come out the same or it sounds the same, but this doesn't sound the same at all.
Oh, thank you. No, I think, yeah, it definitely, each song is its own universe, and that's kind of what I was trying to reflect with the whole use of the Doll's House imagery as well. Each room has its own wallpaper and its own furniture and a different character, and each song is its own little self-contained world.
So it's also, all those rooms in the dollhouse are kind of like the songs, yeah?
Yeah, exactly. Awesome. And yeah, for sure, like, it's an album that traverses a whole range of different styles, and the songs don't sound like each other. And, I don't like those kind of albums where each song bleeds into the next and nothing stands out.
You know? How did that feel when those walls just dropped and everything just started flooding out?
Yeah, it was very liberating, I guess. Maybe I could compare it with some, you know, being nude on stage. I've heard that's a good feeling. It is like that when you bare your soul to someone else during the creative process. You have to, you know, not be afraid of looking like a total dickhead in front of someone else. But once you start to ride that wave, I think the rewards are great.
Yeah, and it's interesting that when I read about that, because as a performer, you're fantastic on the stage, and to say that you needed to drop those inhibitions to songwrite, yet you get up on stage in front of all these people and put on a great show. What's the difference between them?
They're not the same at all. On stage, I'm not myself on stage. Well, I get to explore a totally different facet of who I am, and who I am off stage is, yeah, someone totally different.
Do you remember the shows when you get off stage? Being somebody else on stage?
I remember the vague gist of them. I remember if something went wrong or something went really, really right. But I do feel very in the moment on stage. So it all does sort of, it's like I'm in the time-space continuum is slightly altered. And it's probably, the only time that I truly do feel in the moment.
Kate, thank you very much for joining us on Melbourne Rock City. If you want any more information on Kate and where she's touring, katemillerheidke.com for all her dates. Thank you for joining us.
Pleasure, thanks
Come
for having me.
Come and see us in Melbourne next time you're here, and good luck with the rest of the tour.
Thanks.
If you want to pick up the album, Curious is out now, go get it.
Sexual, but I can't help it, I'm in love.